Hello everybody, I am Rajur Sripal and you are watching Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. So today's topic is, as you can see from the screen, isolator operation or opening or closing of isolator. Okay, isolator is basically a no load device which operates under no load condition. So let's see how the isolators are operated and what are the different criteria for operation of isolator. So let's begin the video. Now first we will see that what is the basic operating condition of the isolator. In general, isolator should be operated under no load condition. Okay, this is the theory. As per theory, isolator should only be operated under no load condition. But there is a big question mark. As per IS 9921, an isolator could be operated when negligible current is broken or made, or there is insignificant change of voltage across the two terminal of each pole. Now watch this 2 point very carefully. This basically supports the philosophy of no load operation. Right, if you see these two conditions carefully, you will understand that it support the no load operating condition. I will explain it later. Now what does negligible current means? Negligible current means capacitance current of bushing or busbar or PT magnetizing current, etc. So these currents are could be directly break or make by our isolator. Okay. And insignificant voltage change across two terminals means basically you are adding a bypass path to the current. Okay, that means another parallel path of current is already exist. Under this condition you also operate the isolator. But why such limitations? Because unlike circuit breaker, isolator is not designed to withstand the arc that is generated during full load breaking. So whenever you are breaking a current, a load current, huge amount of current, or there is a significant voltage difference between two terminal after breaking, then it will create an arc. Okay, suppose you are breaking a current carrying path, so it will create arc. Now this isolator contact does not have the capability to withstand that arc or to extinguish that arc. It doesn't has any arc extinguishing medium. Okay, so every precaution should be make that there is no arc in the two in between the opening contact of the isolator. So when this is possible? This is possible if there is a bypass current path of the isolator. That means across two terminal the voltages are same. If the contact two terminal of the opening contact has same voltage, then there will not be any arc because there is no potential difference. So the voltage will not be able to break down the intermediate air gap, or there is very small amount of current. Very small amount of current will generate very small arc which can be extinguished naturally. Okay, so under this two conditions only the isolator could operate. But remember that although the isolator does not have the withstand capability against arc, but it should be rated for full load current. It should be capable of full rated current continuously, and it has also a short circuit current rating for specific short circuit duration, right? So just like the circuit breaker, it also has say 40 kilo ampere for 1 second short circuit withstand capability. So that is mandatory, but it doesn't has the breaking or making capacity. Okay, so now we will see the isolator operation with animation. That is the most interesting part of the video. So before starting the animation, let us see the legends. Okay, so this is the isolator without any earth switch. This is isolator with one end earth switch. This is isolator with both end earth switch, and this is circuit breaker. So first we will see the single bus scheme. Okay, operation of isolator with single bus bar. So you can see that all the feeders are in open condition. Okay, the bus is de-energized, it has no power or no voltage, and all the isolator, these are isolators and this is circuit breaker, all are open conditions. Earth switch are also open. In this video I will not discuss about the earth switch, I will only check the operation of isolators. Okay, so what will be our first operation? First we will close this bus PT isolator. Okay, so if since the bus is not charged, then if I close the bus PT, then also there will be no current because this bus has no voltage. Also, if the bus is charged, then also you can close the bus PT isolator because that time only the magnetizing current will be made, right? So this could be taken care by the isolator. So first let us close the isolator. So we have closed the isolator. So this bus PT will now connected with the main bus. Now we will close the incomer, both incomer, right? So in that case we have to make the no load operation. So before closing of the breaker we have to close these two isolator. So first let us close this isolator. This isolator is closed and we will close this isolator. Okay, so since the breaker is not closed and there is no other sources, so this isolator will not break or make any current, right? So now the voltage is available up to this terminal. Now we will close this circuit breaker. So this will obviously cause the no load operation of the isolator, right? So now I have closed this circuit breaker. So now this bus is charged at the supply voltage. So now we can charge the second incomer also. For this case also we will first close this isolator, then this isolator, or we can do the reverse. This isolator could be closed first, this isolator could be closed second. Now before closing this breaker we have to match the synchronization, okay, because this incomer has already giving power to this bus bar. So this breaker should be, this power source should be in sync with this power source. So by checking that we can close this breaker also. Okay, so now two incomers are closed. Now what will be the closing of outgoing feeder? Again we will first close these two isolator and then we will close this circuit breaker. So now suppose we have to take this breaker into maintenance. Okay, so how will this isolator will be operated? So first we have to open this circuit breaker because this incomer is now carrying current. So I cannot open this isolator now. So I have to first open this circuit breaker. Okay, so pressing this red button, the circuit breaker is opened, right? Since the circuit breaker has opened, now this path is not carrying any more current. Okay, so now we can open this isolator. So thus we can isolate this incomer too, right? So this is the operation for single bus bar scheme. And for bus PT, if I need to take the bus PT in maintenance, I can just open this isolator because bus PT draws only very small magnetizing current which can be broken by the isolator. Okay, so now we will see the most important and interesting bus bar scheme, that is two main and one transfer scheme. Here you will see all the criterias, like there is insignificant change of current. Insignificant change of current you have already seen because breaking or making of bus PT is implies the insignificant current change. Now in this video we will see that how the isolator is operated when there is same voltage at two terminals of the isolator poles, right? So suppose we have to close this incomer 1 to main bus 1. How will we close? We will first close this isolator. This isolator is closed. Now we will close this isolator. Okay. Now we will close this circuit breaker. So this has been connected to main bus 2. Okay, so this incomer has been connected to main bus 2 instead of main bus 1. Now this incomer is feeding to main bus 2. So we have to connect this outgoing 1 to also main bus 2. So first let me close this isolator, then this isolator, and then this bus breaker. Okay, so now my incomer 1 is feeding to main bus 2 and from here I am taking the power to outgoing 1, right? Now, suppose I have to change the power to main bus 2. Okay, how will I will change? I have to take main bus 2 in maintenance and I have to shift all the powers in main bus 1. So how I will change? Then I have to first close this bus coupler. Okay, first I have to close this bus coupler. So for closing this bus coupler, I will first close this isolator, then I will close this isolator. Okay, see, these operations are all under no load condition. No current is flowing because this circuit breaker is open. Now I will close this circuit breaker. So now you can see that my main bus 1 and main bus 2 are at same potential, right? The incomer 1 is feeding the main bus 2, outgoing feeder is also taking power from the main bus 2, and I have connected main bus 1 with main bus 2 by means of the bus coupler. So main bus 1 and main bus 2 has same voltage now. Okay, that means this main bus 2 voltage is appearing here. Okay, as this is connected, this voltage is appearing here, and main bus 1, this terminal is also taking the same voltage from main bus 1, right? By this medium, by this path, it is also taking the same voltage. So now I can close this isolator because the main load current is going through this path. So if I close this isolator, there will not be any significant current because this two terminal has same voltage. So I will simply close this isolator, right? So see, now my outgoing feeder is taking power from both the buses. Since this isolator has also same potential across the two terminals, so these are basically parallel path. Since this isolator is also taking power from the two buses and has same potential across at the both the terminal of each pole, so I can open this isolator, right? Because if I open this isolator, there will be a possibility of arc generation, but since there is a parallel path, so there will not be any arc. Right, the arc will be automatically extinguished because majority of the load then, I mean major, not majority, 100% of the load will be shifted to this path. So I will open this isolator. Okay, so now see, my entire power has taken from the bus bar 1. Similarly, I have to shift this incomer to bus bar 1 also. Then what I will do, since my bus coupler is closed, I will simply close this isolator and will open this isolator, right? So this is how the isolator is operated. Now I have to remove this bus coupler because my need of bus transfer is already completed. So I can remove this bus coupler. So how I will remove this? I will first open this circuit breaker. So then there is no current through this bus coupler, and I will simply open this two isolator. Okay. So see that all my power is now feeding to main bus 1 and taken from main bus 1, right? Now my power flow path is like this. This is going to main bus 1 and from here this is coming back, right? Okay, so now if I have to take this breaker under maintenance, okay, then what I will do, suppose I have to close the transfer bus, I will take this breaker under maintenance and I will shift the power to transfer bus. So how I will close? In that case, I have to, my power is connected with the main bus 1, right? So I have to connect this main bus 1 to this transfer bus. So how I will connect? I will first close this isolator because here all are open circuited, so there is no current flowing. So I will first close this isolator. Then I will close this isolator and then I will close this circuit breaker. Okay, so now my transfer bus is connected to the main bus 1. Okay, so again my potential at this point and this point has come at same. Okay, because this point has the potential of main bus 1. See, this point is connected to the main bus 1. So this point has the potential of main bus 1. Also, the transfer bus is connected to main bus 1 by the bus coupler. So, this point has also the potential of or voltage of main bus 1. So I can simply close this isolator. Okay. So basically I am adding a parallel path. Now I will open this circuit breaker and I will open this two isolator. Right. So what will be my flow of power? The incoming power will be coming through this path via the transfer bus and this bus coupler. It will be connected to the main bus, right? So basically it is coming through here through the transfer bus from here. Last I show it wrongly. From the transfer bus through the bus coupler, it will be fed to the main bus 1, and again the outgoing is taking power from the main bus 1, and all the protections of this circuit breaker will be shifted to this bus coupler breaker. Okay, so if I have to return to my original condition, how I will return back? See, my transfer bus and my main bus 1 is at same potential, so I can simply close this, and here also there is no current flowing, so I can close this isolator and this circuit breaker, right? So my main bus and the transfer bus is charged, bus coupler is still closed. Okay, now I will simply open this breaker, because my bus coupler is closed, so main bus 1 and main bus 2 transfer bus will be at same potential, main bus 1 and transfer bus will be at same potential, so my voltage across this point and this point will be same. So I will open this isolator, okay, and then I will simply open this circuit breaker and then these two isolators respectively. So by this I will again return to my original position, my standard operating conditions. Okay, so these are the two method of isolator operations. I hope you have understood and you have enjoyed this video. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel, and also please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Thank you very much for watching this video.